Welcome to the Big Four Accounting Firms podcast, brought to you by big4accountingfirms.com. We have a great show today, but before we get to that, I wanted to remind you of a few things. We have two great books on Amazon that will help you get the Big Four job that you deserve, and I've included links to those books in the show notes. Additionally, I wanted to remind everyone to make sure that they subscribe to this podcast to stay up to date on the latest Big Four news and career tips. Also, make sure to share the show with a friend if you get a chance. Lastly, follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn. I'll include links to all our social media in the show notes. Thanks and enjoy the show. Today we are going to be discussing an accounting firm at an award show. And that accounting firm was in charge of counting ballots for said award show. Don't worry, it's not PwC and it's not the Oscars. So everything should be okay. We're going to be discussing E&Y at the 2017 Emmys. On a night where the sole focus should have been on Hollywood and Hollywood's hatred for Trump, some of the jokes actually involved the Big Four accounting firms, which is a decent change. Now on this night, all eyes were on E&Y after what happened at the 2017 Oscars. And as you may or may not remember, PricewaterhouseCoopers botched the 2017 Oscars. The two PwC partners, Martha Ruiz and Brian Cullinan, got the envelope for Best Picture mixed up. They awarded the Oscar to La La Land when it should have gone to Moonlight. Now, they ended up correcting the matter, but not before PwC's reputation was permanently damaged. There was also some worry as to whether PwC would lose the engagement, but PwC leadership got involved and they were able to retain the Oscar engagement. So entering the 2017 Emmys, there was so much spotlight on the Ernst and Young accountants, but it appears like the night went off without a hitch. There's a lot of joking around and references to PwC though, and that isn't a bad thing. Having a focus on you for the entirety of the show was free advertising for Ernst and Young and bad publicity for PwC. Now let's go over what happened specifically as it relates to E&Y and the 2017 Emmys. First off, the Television Academy president, Hema Washington, was approached on the red carpet about the accountants and their roles in the 2017 Emmys in light of what happened at the 2017 Oscars. He said he was confident that there wouldn't be a La La Land type mistake at the 69th Emmy Awards. He said the following, "Our accounting firm is Ernst & Young. We've reviewed our policies and procedures, and we're really confident that it's something that we won't have happen." Hema Washington also said that he felt bad for the people that produced the Oscars and offered the following statement. "I feel for the producers of that show. They are all professionals. That had to be something very hard for them to swallow, and they handled it very professionally." The next thing that happened involving E&Y was their formal introduction at the Emmys. Rachel Bloom introduced E&Y for the standard nod to the accounting firms during the show, which is the only time the actual accountants are in front of the TV, usually, unless they screw up the envelopes, of course. Now, she introduced them with a big song and dance number, and she said the following, "There's only one reason to watch the Emmys, you know, and here it is." And she was tap dancing this whole time, and she said, "The best part of the show, the accountants from Ernst & Young. After the accountants, it's all downhill from here. Accountants, let's make out." You heard that, right? She offered to make out with the accountants, and they did a whole big song and dance number, and she said it was the main attraction of the show. And everybody was waiting to see what she was talking about. Was it some piece about Trump? Was there some skit involving something else? Nobody knew, but then she just introduced the accountants. And the accountants from Ernst & Young then came out and their names flashed on the screen. So talking about that, the actual partners in charge of the ballot counting were Andy Sale, Suzanne DeJong, and Paul Chen from Ernst & Young. And after their introduction, the next skit that made fun of accountants at award shows was a skit between RuPaul and Stephen Colbert. Stephen Colbert was the host of the 2017 Emmys. And there was a sketch between Colbert and RuPaul was playing the Emmy statue. So Colbert was interviewing the Emmy statue and he asked RuPaul a number of questions. And you know, like I said before, RuPaul was supposed to be the Emmy statue. She was dressed like the Emmy statue. And Stephen Colbert, while he's talking to the Emmy statue, said that he had hooked up with the Emmy statue a few times in the past. And what he was referring to here was that there was time where he had won an Emmys in past years. He was using a little bit of innuendo here as well, if you know what I mean. He then asked the statue if there was any chance that they could hook up that night. And RuPaul said, "Sure, but it was up to the accountants at Ernst & Young. And they both had a laugh at that one. And obviously what they were trying to imply was that anybody could win if you leave it up to the accountants and they switch up the envelopes, right? Lastly, Jimmy Kimmel and Stephen Colbert made a joke about what happened at the 2017 Oscars. Since Jimmy Kimmel was the host at the Oscars, and also Jimmy Kimmel was hoping that he would get an Emmy for the Best Late Night Show. Unfortunately, Last Week Tonight with John Oliver won the Best Late Night Show, but Jimmy Kimmel ended up making the following joke anyway. Jimmy Kimmel made a joke about how sometimes the presenters put the wrong name on the envelopes, and he said this to Stephen Colbert, and Stephen Colbert said, "Nope, not tonight." And clearly, this was another joke about PwC and PwC's screw up at the 2017 Oscars, and Jimmy Kimmel was hoping that screw up with an envelope went in his favor instead of screwing up the Oscars that he was involved at. That was obviously a very embarrassing night for him. In conclusion, it was a great night for Ernst & Young because they got a lot of free publicity out of what was a low-key night. The night was primarily about Trump jokes, but the second biggest joke was PwC and PwC's screw up at the Oscars. People were saying things like, "Don't worry, our accountants aren't PwC, so we should be good." I think this just goes to show how big of a brand hit the Oscars were for PwC and how good of a night this was for Ernst & Young. And now that the Emmys are all over, all we have to look forward to is the Oscars coming up next year, and we're all waiting with bated breath to see what happens and how involved PwC will be in that night. Will there be jokes about them? Will they be able to participate in the award show at all? Will they be allowed to do any publicity beforehand? As you remember, last year they did a whole Instagram campaign about where is the briefcase that holds the ballots. I really doubt they'll be able to do that this year. But if you want to keep up to date on all of that, make sure to subscribe to this podcast and share it with a friend. We are a growing podcast and a growing business, and we appreciate your support in helping us grow by sharing this podcast with a friend and giving us a review on iTunes. That way we can bring you the best Big Four content possible. Thanks again.